So there are going to be times that downloading a PDF and the metadata together seamlessly isn't always going to work as easily as I just demonstrated in the previous tutorials. Now let me show you an example of what that might look like. So I'm going to use the JSTOR database one more time. And I'm going to do a search for test reliability. So let's take a look at this first entry called test reliability. Now this is the same source JSTOR that we used previously where we were able to download the PDF and the metadata simultaneously. So we have the link to download PDF and we have cite this item and we have the entry written here. So let's take a look at the Mendeley tool and see what we can get from this. So we'll notice that first of all, the entry doesn't get pulled up on the right-hand side. So that's not going to work for this particular web page that we're on. So let's dive a little deeper and take a look at more specific information of the entry. So I just clicked on the title, and here we are. This is the more detailed entry with all of the metadata information and a preview of the PDF. So once again, let's try and take a look at the Mendeley tab and see what happens. So it's telling us that the bibliographic metadata could not be detected. So the next step that we would do is click on the download PDF itself, so it'll open up in a new browser. Okay, so here's the full PDF. Let's take a look now at the Mendeley tab and see what happens. So it's telling us here that there's no title found and it's not giving us any type of metadata. So if you remember from the previous tutorial, we were using JSTOR similarly to what we're doing here. We got to the point where we pulled up the actual PDF, we clicked on the Import to Mendeley button, and it was able to provide us the PDF as well as all of the metadata that was drawn from the PDF itself. In this particular instance, that doesn't happen. It's telling us here that the PDF is accessible, however, there's no metadata that's associated with this particular article. So there are two routes that we can go. The first is download the PDF and then see if I click that search button, or even if the search button is available, maybe the metadata is already stored within the cloud service and then it'll attach itself to this particular PDF. The second thing we can do is download the PDF and download the citation information separately into two different files and then upload those separately into Mendeley. Now that seems a little bit more laborious, but I would more aptly do the second because in the long run, to me, it's going to be a little bit quicker and I don't have to go back and retrace my steps. So I'm going to show you exactly how to do both and then you can decide the path that you want to take that works best for you. I'm going to save this into the new PDFs folder. And it's telling us that the PDF and the reference was found and stored. However, because it's telling us that the reference was stored, it's going to tell us this no title was found information. So let's take a look at the desktop and see what happens. So we'll see here that the PDF was pulled in, so let's click on the PDF. And let's do a search and see if the metadata is available. So we'll see that there was no search function that happened with this, and so this has not been uploaded into the Mendeley system, and there's no metadata existing for this particular article. So as I said, the last thing that I want to do is go in and have to type in all of this information. If I'm working in an environment where I'm trying to be as efficient as possible and I'm really just trying to download a bunch of information. So there's another way that we can do this. So now what we can do is we'll notice that the PDF is available and the metadata is here. So what we can do now first is download the PDF to our desktop. And I'm going to download it to the desktop. And we'll notice here the PDF is available. It's here on our desktop. However, the title once again is given a random code based upon the particular database system that it's stored in. That's not helpful to us in the long run, and I don't want to spend time typing all of that in. So we've downloaded the PDF. Now I'm going to close out of here, and the next thing we want to do is go to where it says cite this item. If we click on cite this item, It's going to provide all of the citation information for MLA, APA, Chicago Turabian. But then you notice down here, it's going to say export citation. In particular, we want to export an RIS file. Now, what an RIS file is it's a standardized tag format that enables citation programs to exchange data. And it was developed by what's called Research Information Systems. So essentially, it's just a small file that's going to provide all of the metadata. So we can click on here and download that now also onto our desktop. So this is an RIS file. Okay, so now I have the PDF here and I have the RIS file. So what I want to do is I now want to go into my Mendeley system. I'm going to make sure that I'm dragging it into new PDFs. I'm going to take the RIS file. Now, it's important that we do this in this order. First, we're going to drag the RIS file into the bibliographic software. And you'll notice here, all of the metadata has been carried in and the metadata is correct. Now, what I want to do is go into the bottom where it says files, and I want to attach the PDF file to this metadata. So I'm going to click on add file. I'm going to go to my desktop and I'm going to upload the PDF to the entry. And we'll notice here, as we upload the PDF to the entry, it changed the title information. So it has the author, the date, and the title with all of the correct bibliographic data. So that's going to be the fastest way to do that, as opposed to the opposite way, where if we download the PDF into the system and then we're going to have to type in all of the information by hand. Here, we're actually going to do it backwards. We wanted to download the RIS file, download the PDF file, upload the RIS file into the software, and then attach the PDF to that RIS file, and that makes it proper formatting and the proper PDF, and everything is synced properly. I hope you enjoyed the video and found it helpful. If you did, make sure to give us a big thumbs up and like the video. If you haven't done so already, be sure to subscribe to our channel by clicking the link above, and make sure to check out some of our other videos. We'll see you again soon.